Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to drag and drop the appointments from an external source into the Blazor Scheduler. Here, the TreeView component acts as an external source from which I can drag any patient's name and drop into the scheduler as doctor's appointment. Now, let me proceed to show you how to achieve this using the scheduler APIs. First, I am going to open the existing application, where I have added a Blazor scheduler with few normal appointments. To know how to create Blazor scheduler and add appointments to it, please look on to the Getting Started video shown in the above YouTube card, and you can find its reference link from the description part below. Now, let me run this application to show you the output of this example. So here, you can view the scheduler with the normal appointments. As I said before, I am going to use the TreeView component as an external source here. So, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor Navigation's NuGet package into the Blazor application. To install the NuGet package, I will open the NuGet package manager by right-clicking the project and choose the Manage NuGet packages. Then, I will search for Syncfusion Blazor Navigations in the Browse tab and install it into the project. Once the installation gets completed, let me navigate to imports.razor file. And here, I will add Syncfusion Blazor Navigations namespace to start using the Blazor TreeView in any of the components available under the Pages folder. Then, I need to define the TreeView component. So, within this index.razor component, let me include the tag sftreeview. Here, I have added few division tags with the class name to separate the scheduler and TreeView component. Also, I have defined few CSS styles for these division tags within this style section. Now, I am going to display the unscheduled appointment list in the TreeView component. So, let me add the data source by creating a model class TreeView model with two fields, ID and name. Then, I need to create a list of TreeView data of type TreeView model and assign an array of objects to it. Here, to specify the data source type, I will define tValue property with appropriate value. Next, for this data source, the appropriate data source field should be mapped to the fields property of the TreeView component. Therefore, I will define TreeView field settings tag and map the fields name to text property and ID to ID property. And I will also assign this object, TreeView data, to the data source property of TreeView. Now, when you look at the output page, you can find the TreeView component rendered beside the scheduler. Next, I will proceed to show you the code snippet for enabling the drag action on TreeView component and how to save those dragged items from the TreeView component onto the scheduler. First, I need to enable the drag and drop action on TreeView component. So, let me define the property allow drag and drop and set its value as true within this TreeView component code. And now, I can drag an item from the TreeView component, but I cannot drop them onto the scheduler, as I need to write the code for handling this scenario. So, as a first step, I need to define TreeView events tag with tValue property. Then, I will define an event of TreeView on no drag stop, which triggers when an item from the TreeView component is dragged and dropped onto the target area. Within this event, I'm going to write the code for saving the dropped data onto the scheduler. So, let me define the onTreeViewDragStop method, which accepts the argument of type drag and drop event args. And I need to cancel the TreeViewDrop action. Therefore, let me set args.cancel as true within this event. Before I save the dragged item on the scheduler, I should know the time range value on the scheduler where the item is currently being dropped. So, to get the time details of the underlying cells on scheduler, I need to make use of the scheduler's method getTargetCell, which accepts the argument of type integer. Therefore, within this onTreeViewDragStop event handler, let me assign this getTargetCell method to the cellData variable, which is of type cellClickEventArgs. Look at this method, I have passed the target cell left and top value of the scheduler. Now, let me proceed to show you how to access this public method getTargetCell of scheduler. To access any such public methods or properties of scheduler, first I need to access the scheduler component instance. For this purpose, let me add a reference to the scheduler component code and define its instance here. After adding such reference, now you can access them using schedulereference.getTargetCell. Next, let me tell you what this method getTargetCell will retrieve. Here, this method retrieves cell details, and using it, I will form the appointment object if cell data variable is not null. In this appointment object, you can see, first I will assign ID with random number, and subject with TreeView drag node text. Along with this, I also add the start time, end time, and all day information of the target cell. And finally, using the addEvent method of scheduler, I will pass this appointment object as argument to it and save the dropped item onto the scheduler. And now, when I drag an item from the TreeView component and drop it onto the scheduler, you can see that particular item getting added onto the exact time range where I have dropped it. Here, you can also set the built-in editor window to open before saving this appointment to the scheduler by making a call to the OpenEditor method of scheduler instead of addEvent. In this case, the appointment object formed from the retrieved cell details should be passed as an argument to the OpenEditor method, and the addEvent method line should be commented. Now, when I drag and drop an item from the TreeView component into the scheduler, the built-in editor window gets opened, prompting you to add furthermore details, and when you click Save button on the editor window, the appointment will get added to the scheduler. So, that's all about how to drag and drop an event from the external source into the scheduler component. Okay, let me summarize what we have learned in this video. We have seen how to add TreeView component to the existing Blazor application, and how to drag and drop an item from the TreeView component into the Blazor scheduler. Finally, we have also seen how to open the editor window before adding the dropped item as an appointment to the scheduler. If you would like to see the working of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link, which is shared in the description part below. You can also grab your chance of getting a free license key to use our complete Blazor products if you fit into our community guidelines. So check the link given in the description part to know if you are eligible for using our community license. If you find this video as useful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching this video.